Hey guys, welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78, and this is my American Truck Sim Let's Play series. Upload this twice a week. Happy Tuesday, hope you guys are doing well today. We are just north of Las Vegas, Nevada. We're going to take this tri-axle container up to Jackpot. And we got something a little bit special today, and a big shout out to Robert for letting me use this today. It is the Mack Pinnacle. Great looking model, nice looking aero truck, and just breaks up the Packer monotony, which is very much needed in this game. Break up the Kenworth Peterbilt train. Good looking model. Let's go ahead and fire it up. Sounds really good. I will link his channel down in the video description. I'm pretty sure he does plan on releasing this, so check out his channel for updates on that. Great looking truck, and again, thanks for letting me use this. Hop inside, take a look at the interior. Looks really good. Like how it's got the CB up there, nice looking Cobra CB. And it does have, you can't see it, but it does have the shifter in it, so that's really nice. But we'll take a look at our manifest here. We got juice, 41,000 pounds, going to sell goods up in Jackpot. Actually, there we go. Let's go ahead and get started. I'm not real excited to use this truck though. This is the kind of stuff that I'm really wanting to see more of an ATS. Of course, we got plenty of Kenworths with the W900, the T680, plenty of Peterbilts with the 579, the 389, and there's all sorts of variants of different Peterbilts out there, 379s, the Viper 389, and you got the Kenworth 521 out there. You got some different variants of W900s and so forth like that, but not a lot of stuff like this. So very, very excited to take this thing up and down the highway today. Yeah, the track IR, found out the issue is not the track IR itself, but actually the Logitech Momo. I was playing some multiplayer the other night with the guys and everything, and it was doing that very same thing there. And then I started to turn the wheel back and forth just real quick, and it just started bugging out. So I'm not sure why the Momo is interfering with track IR. I have went in the settings in ATS here and turned absolutely everything off that has to do with looking left, right, and all that stuff. So I'm not really sure what it is, but like I said a couple episodes back, the Momo is an older wheel. So maybe it's just not playing nice with Windows 10. Not sure, but if I had to guess, that's probably what it is. So we'll kind of work through it today. If it gets too bad, I'll just go ahead and unplug track IR, and we'll just, you know, do it that way. But no update on the G27. I did reach out to Logitech, and they replied back, just, you know, wanting some basic information. And I filled out all that information on the support website, and it turns out that I still have 2 years left on the warranty for the G27, which I was absolutely shocked, because, you know, I thought since I bought it off of Amazon, you know, refurbished, that it, you know, that there wouldn't be any kind of warranty left or anything like that. But, yeah, still got 2 years left on the warranty, so hopefully, you know, I'm not getting my hopes up or anything like that, but hopefully, you know, something can be done and you can get that thing fixed or get it replaced, and it'd be pretty awesome. But that's where all that is. Other than that, everything is pretty much the status quo. Come on, girl. There we go. And I'm still working on tweaking the settings on the Logitech Momo, the brake settings, the steering sensitivity, all that good stuff, because it is completely different, like I said before, from the G27. And just want to thank you guys for the support. So far this month has started off really good. A lot of new subs, so welcome to all you guys. Thanks for checking out the channel and subscribing. Hope you guys stick around and enjoy the stuff. Really loving the support that I've been getting on the LSPDFR series. I enjoy playing that, and looks like you guys enjoy watching it, so thanks for supporting that. But inching ever closer to 600 subs, so pretty excited about that. Just those little milestones, keep me motivated and kind of just keep me driven to keep on doing this. So thank you guys for the support. And of course, all you guys have been around for a while, thanks for sticking around. Very much appreciated. And I'm not sure what the speed limit is through here, but I'm probably just completely blowing it away. Oh yeah. Yeah, 60 and a 35. I'm sure they just let me off with a warning, right? Probably not. Probably not. Still no news on the map rescale. I did check out the SES blog before I hopped on today, and the only update they had was on Blender Tools. So if you are a modder for American Truck Sim and use Blender Tools, be sure to check out the SES blog. Looks like they had a pretty big update for those tools. I use ZMod 3, so I've not really tried to use Blender, but I might have to check that out because my license is up here in I think the next couple months for ZMod. Not sure if I'm going to renew it or just try to figure out Blender Tools, since that is a free program. And unfortunately, ZMod is not a free program. It's a you have to buy a license for it now, which kind of sucks, but I kind of understand, because earlier versions of ZMod, like ZMod 2 and everything, got pirated so stinking much that, he had to go down the creator of ZMod 3, Oleg, had to, go down this road to where, became a subscription-based service. So, it is what it is, but, I'm not sure what I'm going to do when my subscription runs out, because I don't really mod a whole lot for ATS, so... Yikes. Come on. There we go. There we go. Daggone, I could have just went around there. Not sure why. But, yeah. That's alright, though. Just could have kept going around there. Hopefully that's one of the things they fix in the map rescale is, the GPS just kind of doing goofy little stuff like that instead of just going around, which would be a whole lot easier. Hopefully you don't have to do as much zigzagging and stuff like that. But if I was paying attention, I could just avoid that altogether. So that's just as much on me as anything. I'm gonna wait on the Domino's truck. There we go. It doesn't seem to be as bad, the thing bugging out there. It does not seem to be as bad as it has been the last couple times I played, so... But it is, for whatever reason, like I said, it is something related to the Logitech Momo, so there's not a whole lot I can do about it. But as long as it stays like this, I think it'll be okay. At least it's not, kind of zooming in and out like it was a couple episodes back, which was just crazy. Thank you. hop outside and take a look at the truck here real quick. Just like I said, great looking model. Good looking aero truck. Whoa. And that's why I don't go outside the interior view a whole lot, because I just get crazy and go all over the road. But definitely check out Robert's channel. A lot of great tutorials on just various things ATS related. So if you're looking to learn how to mod the game, definitely check out his channel. And while you're over there, just go ahead and give him a sub too. Super good guy. I think I'm just gonna follow the Domino's guy here and just play it safe. Keeps myself out of trouble that way. Just kind of glanced up at that last billboard there. It looked like some kind of pizza advertisement. I swear it looked like I had a hot dog in the crust. That would be disgusting if that's the case. You know, stuffed crust pizza is pretty awesome, but oh my god, putting a hot dog in there would be borderline inhumane. What is this chucklehead doing? Awesome sounding horn. That's one of the things I really like about Robert's mods, is he usually has some pretty sweet sound and sound mods included with it. Sure why this wheel is just real touchy. Wasn't like that the first couple times I used it, so not sure what's going on. And someone had asked on a recent video, you know, you'll look around in like some of the parking lots or some of the way stations. There's like parked trucks and stuff like that. That is part of, a good example, like right up here on the left. That is part of the MHA Pro map. All they are is just static models, but they add those in there to kind of help the immersion factor and stuff like that. That way, you know, all the parking lots, all the rest areas, all the way stations just aren't, you know, totally empty. So that's what that is. And a link for that will be down in the video description. Trying to get away from the mod spreadsheet and just actually post what mods I'm using in each episode down in the video description, like I do for my LSPDFR series. So that'll be kind of nice. A whole lot easier to keep updated too. Coming up on McGill, Nevada. So I think we came through here the last episode, but was going the other way. I think. Maybe we didn't. don't know, but I just love the MHA map mod. Very well done. Very, very well done indeed. Nice thing about it is it's just an add-on to the stock map, so... Can't wait to see what they do with it after the rescale. Should be pretty awesome. Fuel. Yeah, we could probably use a little bit of go-go juice. So we will stop up here. Let's see, it looks like everything. Oh yeah, this is pretty cool. It's a little bit different, you know, not your standard whoops, not your standard gas station or truck stop, so that's pretty cool. There we go. As we do that, we'll hop out, take a look at the truck, get a nice close-up view of it. Looks pretty good. And I think I failed to mention at the start, this is not released yet, so don't ask for the link because it does not exist yet. But, like I said, check out Robert's channel for any updates on that. And, you know, he's really good about doing that, so be sure to check that out. I think anything's coming, but I really can't tell. Okay. There was not anything coming. Wait for the Ing truck to get past us here, and... Nice looking sunset up ahead. And get our lights on. Yeah, that's pretty epic right there. Be pretty epic if I could keep this thing on the road. There we go. Want to get a screenshot without the HUD up there. Coming around us, they gonna make it, or are they just gonna kind of hang out over there? Shoot in there, buddy. Got places to go. Ah, cool. There was another truck stop. Son of a, what the hell, you stupid son of a bitch. Well, I'm glad they, you know, went flying around me just so they can get in front of me and, you know, almost die. dumbass. I don't know that the speed changed back there, but yeah. Never a dull moment with the AI in this game, that's for sure. Close are we to jackpot? Not too far out. Like I said the last episode, I want to run Nevada a little bit. Haven't done a whole lot of Nevada stuff. At least it doesn't seem like I've done a whole lot of Nevada stuff here lately. Did quite a bit of Arizona after that came out, so kind of neglected Nevada. Did a fair amount of California recently, so kind of want to get up here and run around in Nevada. Yeah, if that was a real cop, he definitely would have stopped and pulled me over there. Came in hot. Pretty good stretch of road through here, and there's plenty of places to stop and park and get fuel and all that good stuff, so that is awesome. Truck wash. Interior on this looks really good at night too. Like how the CB's all lit up. Dash is lit up all nice. Got our speed set right there at 55 and good to go. Brights on so we can see a little bit better. Not seeing any traffic out, so that's kind of nice. Got the highway all to ourselves. And we are coming up on jackpot. A nice little run here. Track IR behaved for the most part, so yeah. We're just gonna go ahead and follow the GPS. So it looks like we maybe could have went up, but rather be safe than sorry. Could be the only entrance to the place is back here, so. Truck just sounds really good though. Really, really good. Sell goods should just be up here on the left. Right here. We can give it a shot. We can give it a shot. Looks like we're going between that flatbed and that other trailer, but man, with that truck there, that is not a good place for that truck. I'll tell you that right now. If not for that thing there, it'd be pretty easy to get this thing backed in. And it's weird not having the clutch and all that stuff, because I have to use the brake pedal as reverse with this automatic, and it's just goofy as all hell. At least to me it is. I don't know. Maybe I can get this thing turned around and angle it back in there. You know, like having the static models in here, but having one right in the middle of the parking lot, not so much. Not so much. Now we'll give that a go. I guess it wasn't too bad. Now let's pull up, straighten out, and we should be good. There we go. That is good enough for me. Reasonable. Eh. Meh. All right, guys, that is going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. Hope that you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give it a like and a share. It just helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. But guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.